Progesterone is a natural hormone which is present in your body already. This is very, very important to prepare your uterus before the fertilized egg comes and sits in it, and also to maintain the pregnancy in the initial few months. Now, in natural conception, your body produces enough progesterone which helps in the conception and also in maintaining of the pregnancy. While when we give fertility treatments like IUI or IVF, this may or may not happen. For example, in IVF, medications are given to produce and stimulate your eggs. This may suppress the progesterone production. In IUI, there may be a need to support your second half of your menstrual cycle, which we call as the luteal phase, especially if you've had any history of miscarriages or if there is progesterone deficiency. Now, how is progesterone administered during IVF procedure? Now, what are the do's and don'ts associated with this progesterone administration? Hello everyone, this is Dr. Sneha Shetty, Clinical Director, Chief Fertility Specialist, Laparoscopic Surgeon and Gynaecologist working at Vriksh Fertility, HSR Layout and Whitefield. Why do doctors prescribe progesterone during fertility treatment? Let's start with the basics. Progesterone is a natural hormone which is present in your body already. This is very, very important to prepare your uterus before the fertilized egg comes and sits in it, and also to maintain the pregnancy in the initial few months. Now, in natural conception, your body produces enough progesterone which helps in the conception and also in maintaining of the pregnancy. While when we give fertility treatments like IUI or IVF, this may or may not happen. For example, in IVF, medications are given to produce and stimulate your eggs. This may suppress the progesterone production. In IUI, there may be a need to support your second half of your menstrual cycle, which we call as the luteal phase, especially if you've had any history of miscarriages or if there is progesterone deficiency. Now, how is progesterone administered during IVF procedure? Now, different methods are available and your doctor may choose accordingly based on your need and based on the cause for which they are giving you the progesterone. It could be either in the form of oral progesterone, vaginal progesterone, or it could also be intramuscular injections. And nowadays we have amazing subcutaneous injections of progesterone which are not that painful as well. Now, what are the do's and don'ts associated with this progesterone administration? First, let's discuss about the do's. Number one, stick to your doctor's prescription. Do not miss any dosage. Number two, be mindful of the side effects of progesterone. You may experience a little bit of fatigue, mood swings, etc., which may be common. But if you're experiencing severe reactions in the form of itching, uneasiness, inform your doctor immediately. Number three, take the medication in a proper technique. Sometimes taking an intramuscular injection subcutaneously, taking a vaginal medications orally may cause problems in the absorption and may decrease the efficacy of the medication which is prescribed. Next is proper storage. Certain form of progesterones like gels, tablets may be required to be maintained in certain temperature. So always discuss regarding this with your pharmacist or with your doctor. What are the don'ts? Don't stop your progesterone medication suddenly. Always inform your doctor and follow the instructions properly. Number two, don't skip your medications. Number three, avoid wearing tight clothes after your vaginal medication. Opt for loose, breathable fabrics. Next is don't ignore any abnormal symptoms like excessive vaginal discharge, which is associated with severe itching, rashes in your vagina, or rashes on your injection site, etc., have to be reported to your doctor.